Hi, my name's Luke Layton. I started the Rhombus Tech Initiative. This is our first CPU card. It's credit card sized, and it's a standalone computer in its own right, and it goes into the side of a laptop, a tablet, any mass volume appliance. This is the first one that we're doing, and it has an all-winner A10 processor, a gigabyte of RAM. We're working on a CPU card which has a quad-core processor, and in about 18 months' time, we should have access to Intel 22 nanometer processors as well. The whole point of this is to save on environmental costs and also to simplify product development. So the factories that we're speaking to absolutely love this from two perspectives. The first perspective that they love it from is the fact that the CPU cards are shared across multiple products. So they can, in the very short timescales in which these smartphone style and tablets and processors exist and can be sold, they can share the exact same CPU card across 10, 15 products. The second reason they love it is because the products that they can put these cards into do not have to change at all, unless the components go end of life. So as long as the components are cost competitive, they can keep making that product for 5 to 10 years. Now that's a fantastic opportunity for both the product makers and the suppliers of the components. From an end user perspective, it's fantastic because they can buy one product, they can keep it until it dies a death, until it breaks and falls apart. And during that product's lifetime, if they can keep it running for 4 or 5 years, they can keep upgrading the CPU card. They don't have to pay money to buy an entire new product. All right, so there's environmental savings, cost savings, product development cost savings. I can't begin to get across how advantageous the process is, and I can't understand why somebody else hasn't come up with it already. Thank you for listening.